Reggaeton Hellberg.
All right, let's finally do the breakdown for my semifinal submission in the Kenny Beats beat battle. We've got the intro here, as you can see. The drop is over here, and then we got some automation that controls like instrument groups up there, and just some effects down here. Not that important. All right, let's start with the verse, and then we'll go on from there. We got the synths here, obviously. That is kind of the main thing. Got a piano. Got a little sparkling synth from Prophet. Also got an organ here. Which sounds super shitty, but it kind of works. I probably should have chosen something that sounds more real, but it works for what it's doing. Also got the sub. And the MIDI, which is the exact same patch from Omnisphere as the sub. It's just really distorted and obviously low-cutted. And there's some chorus on there as well, I believe. Yeah. Yeah, and then we have the big kind of synth. Which is basically a regular saw synth. It just has this little tremolo effect in the high frequencies. So it's like, which I kind of liked. I also got the ARP that's going through the whole thing here. Very pretty. This is also from Prophet. Let's listen to how that sounds without any effects. Yeah, very, very different from what it actually sounds like in the song. But we got some EQing, taking away the most clickiness of it, and also a lot of bottom. Got a sound shifter here that takes it up an octave. Sometimes I like to use sound shifter and take and like go an octave higher with the instrument instead of doing it in just the piano roll, just because it adds some artifacts to it, for sometimes can be kind of cool. Then we have a chorus, a decapitator, vintage verb, RC20. It's really the Hellberg, the Hellberg channel rack here. All right, let's get to what everyone's been asking about. How did I do the choir that sings Kenny Beats? Well, unfortunately, I did not have a choir available to everyone's surprise. I mean, I know a couple of people that sing in choirs, but I did not go and reach out to them. I got a new plugin that I've never used before called Backup Singers, I think. Yeah, Backup Singers from East West, who do a lot of like Hollywood strings, big orchestra plugins. They got some really advanced stuff, and this one was, you know, not the easiest to figure out, but we kind of, you know, we kind of figured it out. And I'm sure that everyone is right now on Google looking up this plugin. So this is how it sounds like with just the plugin. Now, since that's not super clear what they're saying, I added my own little vocal take on top of it.
Kenny Beats, Kenny Beats.
This has SPL transient designer on top of it because I wanted the consonants, the K and the K and B, to be much clearer than they were in the plugin. And to make it even more clear, I added my own little extra thing that just says K and B. So that's weird, but it works, and I'm super glad. I was actually really, really worried that Kenny wouldn't hear what I was doing with the choir, that he would just like hear that I was singing something, but that he wouldn't notice, and that would kind of ruin the whole thing. We also have a regular choir here that's just doing an ooh. We also have a little mellotron string coming in here. Which plays really nicely with the arp and the chords and the other solo that's panned to the left. And we got this little string panned to the right. And everything is just like a really nice stereo image. Yeah, this is the problem with this choir plugin, is that it always messes up in what order it's supposed to sing. All right, let's move on to the vocal here that comes in and sings the Oh Susanna, Alabama thing. I come from Alabama with a banjo on my knee. So this is me singing, but obviously with a lot of effects. It's mellow-dined a lot as well. And all the processing is basically done in the vocal synth. Like, without that, it sounds like... I come from Alabama with... Yeah, just very robotic and auto-tuned. But with the vocal synth, the little thing that I got together here, it sounds way cooler. I come from Alabama. We also have this little Alabama, which is also me singing. And I love that part so much, it just makes it so sound so majestical. Next up, we have the little flute thing here, which is actually a theremin. I think that's how we say it. It's an omnisphere. I use this a lot because the tremolo in a theremin is pretty cool. All right, moving on, we have the transition into the drop here. So the whole transition base is based on this serum plug. And that synth we kind of need to transition into the new key. This whole section here is in A minor or C major, whatever you prefer. What I wanted to transition into was a lower key, because if I was doing a drop in A minor, I would want the bass to be in A. And that's not the best note for an 808 when you want a hard hitting drop. The best like range is from D sharp up to G. We transitioned this into an E minor so that this whole thing is focused on the E note. And then we have a little build up here. And then the drop. So the vocal here is from the sample. Some people were asking where the sample was, and it is mostly right here. And obviously I sang my own thing based on the sample back in the intro, but this is where the sample is at. So believe it or not, this is actually Alex Trebek singing. I took the sample that we got, put it into RX7, removed all the instruments basically as much as I could. I then put it in Altar Boy, made it in robot mode. It makes it monophonic so that there's no melody. It's just like one note. I'll show you. If it wasn't in robot mode, it would sound like this. I mean, it's not bad, but this is much cooler. I had a completely other idea at first. We could listen to that up here, maybe. So my first idea was, I'm coming from Alabama, picking up any on my plate. I'm going to Louisiana. But I think this turned out way cooler with, like, I come from Alabama. Bum, 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 bum. Yeah, when I figured out that pattern, I was so happy with myself. I was jumping around the studio. So let's take a look at the drums in the drop. We have my boy OOYAHs 808 here doing the heavy lifting. y'all need to go and support the boy. We also have a little widening thing here. It just widens out the 808, which does a lot to the big hit here in the one. Like, oh, that does so much. Clap is a regular dwilly clap, a murder snare, and for medicine, a little percussion that adds a little twinkle to it. Here's an old ass loop that I found in my splice library that I've had for like 2 years or something. Also, this little hit here is nice. Like almost like a tambourine, but it's not really. Yeah, then we have the outro here with Kenny's own vocals. I don't know if he noticed on stream, but this is him rapping. The only time I think he's ever gotten bars down on the stream.
Brought his bitch to the cave, told her don't overthink shit.
Which was a fun little outro thing I did just for the Discord and for the memes.
Brought his bitch to the cave, told her don't overthink shit.
In like a Timbaland voice, like
told her don't overthink shit. Ooh.
That was basically my submission for the semifinals, guys. Tomorrow is the big day. I'm recording this on Friday. Tomorrow, Saturday, is the big finale. So that will be really exciting. I'm kind of stressed out already. It's going to be very exciting to see who comes out on top. Please subscribe, leave a comment and a like if you enjoyed this little breakdown. And I'll see you guys soon.
Reggaeton Hellberg.